Hey guys, you're listening to the Chunky Funky Hour with Nono Malo and
Big Big
on Vaquero Radio. Hello, can y'all hear us? Are we here?
Check the app.
Let's see.
Are we live?
Yes.
Yes, we are live. Welcome back, guys. This is exciting. We're back for
another week.
Hour with us. Before we start our show, we're going to go into a quick little music break with Doja Cat. Say so. Mm-hmm.
Hey guys, you're listening to the Chunky Funky Hour with Nono Malo and
Big Big
on Vaquero Radio. Hey guys, yes, we're back. Well, Vic is on a call, but I'm gonna be here with you guys. So, I want to talk about the Super Bowl, okay? And Tampa Bay won, duh, right? And so that makes me happy because I like Florida. My usual team is the Dallas Cowboys, but I'm not really, like, they obviously didn't go to the Super Bowl, right? But whatever. But Tampa Bay did, and so did Kansas Chiefs, and I like Florida more. But also, the weekend, we got to discuss. I wanted to tell Vic about this, but he's currently a little bit occupied, so that's fine. But le faltó. I don't know about y'all, pero le faltó. Like, he, for a one-man show, it was good. I'm not going to say it was a bad show because it wasn't, but le faltó poquito. And for anyone being like, well, it's because COVID, he couldn't really bring. First of all, he had like 100 dancers on that stage and the choir members. But I feel like he could have delivered a little more. Oh, Vic's coming back. Hey, Vic, what's up? So I'm telling Vic, the people, about The Weeknd, his performance. I don't know what you thought about it, but I was not the biggest fan.
I apologize. I was in a phone call. What were we talking about? What are we talking about? Okay, the Super Bowl, correct? Okay, cool.
Yes.
I didn't watch it.
You didn't watch it?
Nope. Well, so I can't put my opinion on it.
It's okay. But I wish you could have done more of it, because you know what?
I did see clips because, of course, Twitter. Twitter will drag you. Twitter will drag you.
They did.
I was going to say, I don't know. The one that I found funny was that he was inside the box or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
And he had the cameraman holding him and moving him around. And, of course, TikTok had to come in and do it the little clip. And it was, like, people with their phones. And they were just, like, being strangled. Like, oh, my gosh. Like, I have to follow The Weeknd. Just thought it was funny.
Visually, it was really pretty. I can't lie and say it was a bad set. It was not. I just think he could have brought people on. And I shouldn't compare artists to other artists because that's not fair, right? And plus, he's going through a pandemic situation. But I was telling the people, Vic, that, I mean, he had 100 dancers on that stage and on that football field.
Where's the mask? Where's the social distancing?
Like, I'm joking. I don't know. No. Yeah, but I mean, like, the fact that he didn't bring anyone, and, like, if someone wants to justify and be like, what's his COVID?
So it was just him?
It was him. Yeah, it was just him. He didn't bring anyone on.
Oh,
I mean, it was cool. It was good. I'm not gonna say it was bad because it wasn't.
It was bad.
I just wish que le faltó al homie. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He was missing a little pizzazz.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I was not the biggest fan of the thing. People were saying like it's been the best performance. I'm like, you didn't see J Lo and Shakira last year. You lying, because J Lo and Shakira. And you know what, Vic? I love Beyonce. I love Beyonce, and I feel like Beyonce delivered a good show. But I might say, I'm going to risk and say that I think J-Lo and Shakira delivered above and beyond Beyonce. And I'm a big Beyonce fan. Like, big. So, The Weeknd fell a little short, in my opinion. But it was good. It was good.
It was good. I don't know. I can't say because, of course, I didn't watch it. But, I don't know. I just can't say. Honestly, I just can't say. I don't know what you want me to do, Noe.
It's okay. Vic, okay, so you were telling me before we entered the
show. Oh, yeah, I had an epiphany.
Spill, what is going on?
Okay, so, I don't know. Lately, I've been feeling, like, not down, but I've been feeling like I'm not in control of my life completely. I've just been flowing through the waves, I guess. And yesterday, I was in the shuttle going to Edinburgh because, of course, I sometimes work from the Edinburgh campus. I'm originally from Brownsville. because y'all didn't connect the dots right there. And I took a nap and I woke up and I feel like, you know, like, ugh, like another day, right? So I was walking on campus and I was thinking to myself, like, why do I feel this way? Why do I drag? Like, and then I was remembering, I think it was a video, I'm not sure, a quote. And it said like, we're in control of our lives and I don't know what. And then I was thinking to myself, like, yeah, I am in control. So I don't know. I woke up the following day, which, you know, today, the following day, I woke up today, mm-hmm. and I was like, today's going to be different. And I saw this video and where they said, count to three and jump, or not jump, but like do what you're intending to do. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
As in, like, you're on your phone, you're getting distracted, you're doing homework. Count to three, one, two, three. Put your phone down and start doing your homework. And that's what I did today. I wanted to wake up at 6 just to catch up on some homework. My alarms went off. I opened my eyes, like, one, two, three, and I just stood up. And I was like, and I don't know. It's a different day today.
Well, that's good, Vic. I'm glad you realize you're in control. I learned that with UNIV, and it's really like, sometimes you feel like you can't maneuver things, but you really can.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as students, I feel like, for example, I just learned about, like, for example, if I got a bad grade on a quiz, I just need to study for the next one.
Mm-hmm. Or it's not the end of the world.
Yeah, like, we're so in control. There's things that are out of our control, but we have control of our daily lives, at mm-hmm. least. And that's what's awesome, you know? And then before I continue, we have a viewer that I know is tuned in.
So a listener.
Yes, a listener.
A viewer. Come on.
I'm sorry. Shout out to my friend Veronica Ramirez. She's tuned in. She sent me a Snapchat. So shout out to Vero. Hey friend, how you doing? And so shout out to Vero. But I mean,
Veronica what?
Veronica Ramirez.
Oh, hello. Is she my cousin? Is she my sister?
Know. Maybe. I'll let
is
her
she
know.
My sister? My last name is Ramirez too. Hello.
My mom's also tuned into the show.
Hello, Mama Noe. it's my mom tuned in. I sent her a link last week to our show. And I asked her, what do you think of the show? And she was like, oh, I just listened to her for like 5 minutes. Or like, aww. I listened to her for like a little bit. And I was like, well, hello to my mom. She's listening in.
Aw.
Or whatever.
But
I don't care. I don't care.
Back to your epiphany, Vic. We really, truly are in control.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like it's hard because the pandemic is like a routine. Like, yeah. I feel like we're just doing homework
and
sometimes.
And I think that's what I realized as well. It's just the pandemic. Like I was listening to this podcast and they were saying that they just dragged and some people are picking up hobbies. Some people are changing their routine. And I think that's what I need. Cause since the pandemic hit, everything has just been a routine
mm-hmm.
from here on out. Yeah. Just wake up, do work, do some homework in between, go to class, do some work again. And that's the end of the day.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm changing the rhythm. And like you and Navy did teach me some stuff, and I guess that's what happened in my first year. That's why I was motivated, because it was a new year and I was learning all this stuff, like how to approach things. And I guess throughout time you lose touch of that, I guess.
Yeah, but I mean, maybe we can give some tips. Like, I don't know how much time.
Maybe after a break
we'll give more tips.
We'll see what happens,
and we'll give more shout outs, guys, if you message us. So let us know,
or tweet at us.
What's at Chunky Funky Hour.
I'm joking.
Let me, because there might be a the.
Oh my gosh. I have it here. You don't even know our own handle.
At Chunky Funky Hour. Exactly. I was actually correct the first time. Mm-hmm. So I'm just letting you know.
All right. We're going to go into a quick little break and we'll be right back.
Right back, guys.
Vaquero Radio is now available on the palm of your hand.
With Radio FX. Download the Radio FX app to listen to your favorite DJs on the go.
For more information, go to utrgvradio.com.
Station with the latest news
and the biggest hits.
Vaquero Radio,
the Valley Student Station.
Hey,
Hey guys,
you're listening to the Chunky Funky Hour with Nono Malo and
Big Big
on Vaquero Radio. Wasa wasa.
Wow, what a good song.
Honestly, that was pretty good. That was a pretty good song.
I felt motivated. I wanted to work out here at the studio.
That's your motivational song?
Yes. Like? I found this during the weekend, I think. And I was like, wow, I like this.
And you know what, Vic? I feel like we're on the same wavelength because I just put up on Instagram today.
I saw.
That I wanted in motivational
music
songs to do my homework.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like we're on that same wavelength. But a bit, okay, so a tip I wanted to maybe we can give Vic. I don't know what maybe yours is music. One of my other tips for, I guess, staying motivated through the pandemic, which is a random topic that we just started to discuss, that we're going to discuss about. But one of my things is...
Nothing's random started, here at the Chunky Funky Hour.
That's true. That's very true. So I don't know about y'all, but when we were in the pandemic, like as in we were stuck at home just working and class, like we were literally stuck doing that, I would wake up, because I know people lost motivation, I would wake up and make sure I did my hair and put on a polo. But that was just me, my way of feeling like I was being productive. Mm-hmm. And it worked. And it really worked. And I'm really big on, like, dressing up whenever I try and go to work. There's days where I might wear a hoodie or maybe, like, just a simple tee that's a solid color. But some days I just really don't want to, like, feel down, so I have to dress up.
It's crazy how you can trick your mind.
Yeah.
Into thinking that you're being productive. As in, like, just change your shirt to a polo and... you'll feel a little bit different.
I guess it's the material. Like, you feel much more snug, so you feel like you have to be moving around. And
mm-hmm.
I don't know. That's my technique.
Yeah.
One of my techniques mm-hmm. for feeling productive. Vic, do you do anything besides music with yours? Or, like...
I guess not necessarily, like an everyday thing. But what I'm starting to notice is that it's going to sound repetitive. It's going to sound, oh, I already heard this so many times. Drinking water, you know, workout. At the same time, don't work out, you know, if work, be active. Just be active. Not work out. Be active. Move your body. Have the blood moving. That's what I noticed is that you got to move. You got to move, eat better, I guess. And you'll see a difference. Maybe not a huge difference. You're like, well, I won the difference. You know, I wanted to show already. It takes time. And that's what I'm noticing as well. I've been drinking a lot more water. I've been trying to think more positive, and I think it's helping a little bit. I know I have a long way to go, you know.
And you know, Vic, another reminder or another tip that I have to do homework or schoolwork, just in general, like if you're a full-time worker or if you're a student, if you don't mind, it's not a mess, but I always put sticky notes on my laptop in the inside to be like, okay, like on the bottom of the keyboard, there's extra space. I always put there my to-do list for the week. So when I open my laptop, it's literally right there. And that really helps, honestly. And I barely started, Vic, and maybe you had one since a long time, but I didn't, an agenda.
Mm-hmm.
And it really does help.
It does help a lot.
Like a to-do list it's amazing.
And as well as stretching. Maybe not even workout, just stretching. And there's actually a cool little website called Darebee, DareBee.com.
Okay.
They have panels or like little posters in which you can do stretches, you can do workouts. There's a panel there or like a little poster that says everyday stretches. And it makes you, it gives you a guide on like how to move or what muscles are you hitting.
Yeah.
You know, even stretching.
And you know what, Vic, you mentioned earlier, podcasts, and now relating it back to this.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many.
We are a podcast.
Now that you mention it, there's so many podcasts that are like yoga podcasts or just waterfall podcast, like anything that's soothing. If that helps you, play one on Spotify if you have it. It's free. Well, it's
cool,
not free.
What's
but.
Cool about Spotify is that they're public playlist. And if you even look it up, I looked this one up because I thought it was funny. Music that makes me feel like a villain. And there's a playlist and the songs are like hard rock or like very intense music. And I was like, wow, this is really cool. Thought it was funny.
I have some too that are like motivational, but it depends on the mood. Like there's gym motivational. There's like,
oh, yeah.
like I guess my reggaeton motivational, and then there's like school motivational, you know? So I have those. I had actually a playlist, Vic, for when I got my wisdom tooth removed, or my four wisdom teeth removed. Mm-hmm. And that was a motivational one because I was just laying in bed. So I would listen to that playlist. And I mean, it's amazing what you can do on Spotify. Mm-hmm. But I mean, yeah, I mean, I think me and like Vic are going through the quarantine blues a little bit, maybe. But I mean, I'm fine. It's just I'm stressed about homework. Personally, I'm stressed about homework.
Especially, you know? Our last semester.
Yeah.
For me, this semester has been a lot easier than my previous semesters. Oh my gosh. Last semester was bad. The previous semester when COVID hit, it was pretty intense because everything was moving to online. But I don't know. That's just me. Maybe I got lucky with my classes this semester. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, professors are understanding better, I guess, quote unquote, that, you know, the pandemic, it's affecting everyone. I don't know.
I'm not saying
that my professors are bad. I love my professors.
Shout out to my professors. Hopefully they're tuned in. I sent them the link, so hopefully they're tuned in. But, Vic, actually, when COVID hit, I had maybe, I think, three classes in person or two, and the rest were online. So I was used to it. Mm-hmm. I was really used to it. Mm-hmm. But I mean, hopefully we get to maybe be back on campus. Well, I mean, I don't know about you and I.
We're on campus already.
But I mean, like, as in full, like, class. I don't think for the semester, you know.
I got you.
So we'll see. We'll see. I don't know.
We'll see. But we're going to go into another quick little break, music break. And we're going to talk about Terry Crews.
Yes.
Oh, ooh. You forgot, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
You forgot. Okay. And we'll be
right back.
Introducing Vaquero Radio on Radio FX, the one way to interact with the Valley's official student station. You can interact with DJs, participate in polls and contests, view our vast schedule of genres and DJs, and get alerts when your favorite DJ is live. To download the Radio FX app, open the App Store on iPhone or Google Play on Android. Then search for Radio FX. From there, download the app. Once downloaded, you'll be guided into creating a Radio FX account using Facebook or email. Once set up, search for UTRGV and click on Vaquero Radio. From here, favorite the station by clicking on the star icon on the top right. When listening to Vaquero Radio, you can interact with our station by clicking on the Go button. We hope you enjoy using the Radio FX app. We will be sending updates on our social medias with new ways to interact with our station and joining mobile events. Wherever our music can take you, exciting things await in your pocket with Vaquero Radio on Radio FX.
Station with the latest news
and the biggest hits.
Vaquero Radio,
the Valley Student Station.
Hey guys,
you're listening to the Chunky Funky Hour with Nono Malo and
Big Big
on Vaquero Radio. And we're back.
Hello.
Hello.
Why did I whisper? That was weird. I apologize about that.
Oh, my. So, Vic, Terry Crews.
No. Oh, yeah. They're going to do something else. So, what did you think of his speech or, like, his virtual visit here?
I honestly, it was super cool. I'm super, like, I guess, I don't know if honored or, like, just, I'm still starstruck that he was our speaker. Mm-hmm. And I just thought it was super cool. Like, he's so nice. Like, he's so positive and has such a bright energy to him. And I feel like he was the perfect person I think we needed right now during this, like, COVID situation because he just radiates positive energy.
I did not expect the things that he was going to say during his virtual visit. Mm-hmm. Speakers usually talk about their struggles and stuff like that, but I think it was just different, I guess. Mm-hmm. And from what I noticed from different speakers and stuff like that is that whenever, you know, a student gets to be chosen and be up there, you know, virtually in front of everybody and asking their questions, you know, how they're, like, super thankful, it's because, you know, there's not a whole lot of positive recognition here in the Valley. It's usually always about the border wall, immigration and stuff like that. So I guess having someone famous, you know, going through some similar stuff that we might be going through, you know, I guess that's why students are super thankful having a speaker show up to the Distinguished Speaker Series.
I thought it was really cool. I don't know. He was really nice.
Did you see him when he logged in? He was moving his pecs.
No, well, okay.
But it was funny.
I saw him do it once, but I didn't see him the first time because I logged in a little bit later. But I logged in right on time for my professor, Dr. Ulibarri.
So you went in half of the speech?
Yeah, because I started homework and then I forgot that it was Monday, so I didn't get to like see it from the beginning. But when I logged in, I saw Professor Ulibarri, which is my professor, and he's been my
professor. He has some good questions.
Yeah, yeah. He's been my professor for like the past like four, maybe like all of my semesters at UTRGV, mm-hmm. and I was so excited. I was freaking out that he got to like interview him or like ask him questions. And I thought he was a great person overall. I really liked him. He's really cool.
Yeah. He had some good questions as well. I didn't think that he was going to answer them, you know, but he answered them better than I expected. Not that, I don't know. I'm making seem like you know, celebrities don't you know, struggle, because that's the way I guess we see them in a way. But seeing him, you know, open up and mm-hmm. talk about his past, I didn't know he had to go through all that. I was like, damn.
Mm-hmm. And he's a big activist. I mean,
yeah.
I follow.
I like what he said, that he contributes to the community, but anonymously.
Yeah,
that was cool.
Mm-hmm. And I didn't know he was a big activist because I follow his career. I don't follow it like fully, but I did have him. I do have him on Instagram, and he's a big activist, or he has like many things like the Me Too movement. I didn't know he was a supporter of that. I know he also explained that he was a victim. So, and I loved how he was talking about how as men we should be able to tell our male friends, but like speak up, but also like tell male friends in a situation like when they're disrespecting women, like we don't do that here. Like it doesn't have to be disrespectful.
I like that response. He wasn't being disrespectful or anything like that. He just said, we just don't do that here.
We just don't do that.
And basically, he just left it like that for them to I guess, define what they mean. I guess, I don't know. I'm not making sense.
He was, like, perfect, I guess. But that's too much of a title to put on someone, but he was really good. He was really good. Who do you think, Vic, or who would you want to see? Like, if let's say we were not graduating, who would you want to see in fall? Or, like, the next following years?
Good question. I don't know. I honestly don't know. I don't have a celebrity, like, a favorite celebrity to mm-hmm. show up, or, like, someone I look up to. Oh, I know. Tom Hanks?
He'd be cool.
Tom Hanks? Is that how you say his name? Tom Hanks?
Yes.
Yeah, Tom mm-hmm. Hanks, yeah.
I think I would love to see AOC.
Oh,
she would be awesome. 100%. She would be amazing to get. Who else could we get? I'm thinking of who's been doing work lately. Could they get Bernie Sanders? I don't know. I'm headed more toward a political area or like figures.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's what's going on a lot currently. A celebrity that's been doing stuff. I don't know. I mean,
the Obamas.
Oh, one of them. One of them could be. That would be awesome. That would be super cool.
Both Michelle and Barack Obama?
Michelle Obama. Wow. Distinguished speaker.
I want to ask her, why did you make our pizza taste like cardboard?
Why did you give us two chicken nuggets instead of five? I was starving, ma'am.
Do you remember this? I'm not sure if anybody... BISD, because we're both BISD students.
Mm-hmm.
It was... They started giving out pizza, Domino's pizza, on Wednesdays.
But
students would go crazy. And there was one time I got there early and I got the pizza because I could never get the pizza because everybody would like storm into the cafeteria.
Yeah.
And I got the pizza and I was like, oh, wheat bread.
Yeah.
Oh.
And you know what, Vic?
And it tasted like school pizza just with Domino's, with like a Domino piece of paper.
Mm-hmm. I miss Obama. You made me eat like three French fries for. But you know what, Vic? Do you remember how we would eat one slice of pizza
because with chocolate?
We were kids. Yeah, we were kids though. But I mean, my adult body cannot just process one pizza slice
anymore. Like, I eat one pizza and I'm done for the day.
Like, give me, you know, I want three slices. Like, I mean, like, but imagine in high school, like, oh, like,
here's one slice. Well, it's because I got heartburns, that's why.
Oh, okay, okay. But I mean, well, high school, they gave you like fries and potato on the side or something with it, but one slice? Mm-hmm. I wouldn't be able to survive. Me desmayo.
I get you.
Dame unas tortillas con la pizza o algo.
Do you have any announcements, Noe?
Any announcements? Yes. I would like to announce the Career and Internship Expo that the Career Center is having next week, Friday 19th, from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Let me pull up the page for the exact details.
Noe. We went through this last week. No, you're always pulling things out last minute.
It's okay. It's okay. Our podcast is random, okay? Career Internship Virtual Expo. It'll be Friday next week, February 19th, from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. If you guys want to RSVP for it, make sure you go on Handshake. As well, if you want to see the employers, it'll be under there. If you're underclassmen, go and network and maybe find an internship. And if you're a senior, make sure you go look maybe for a full-time job for this graduating May if you're going to be leaving. But yeah, so make sure you check it out, guys. If you have any questions, email us at careercenter@utrgv.edu. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Did you know that our shows are uploaded on YouTube?
They are.
Vaquero Radio.
And students need to pre-register. I'm sorry.
Ah, come on. You ruined the flow. No way. No, I'm
sorry.
Joking.
What was going on?
You can access our shows through YouTube, through Vaquero Radio.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah. So as soon as we're done here, hopefully our radio show will be up within the 24 hours.
Okay.
And we'll be able to see our own show.
That'd be awesome, Vic. So we can like share it on Facebook then?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Or for our listeners who are tuning in a little bit later, they can tune in on YouTube and see. Of course, music will be cut out because copyright and, you know,
Oh. We
don't want to get sued. Whatever. I don't care. Nah. No, but yeah. We're going to go into a quick little break and we'll be
right back.
The station with the latest news
and the biggest hits.
Vaquero Radio.
The Valley Student Station.
Hey guys,
you're listening to the Chunky Funky Hour with Nono Malo and
Big Big
on Vaquero Radio. And we back.
Hello.
So, Vic.
Oh, no.
So
I didn't do it.
No, it's okay.
I promise you.
Well, Valentine's is a Sunday, but whatever. We're going to
move. Oh, my gosh. Valentine's. That was me singing.
Do you know, Vic?
I'm not doing anything. Don't even ask me.
It's okay. Do you know if there's sugar-free chocolate? That's a no.
Do you hear the silence?
That was a no.
That's my answer.
Okay, no,
I'm joking.
I need to look.
Is there?
I don't know. I'm not too sure.
Do you want chocolate without sugar?
I was gonna get it. Well, yeah, for myself, like, oh, sad for me. But I wanted to see if there was anything. But I'm not sure.
Let's look it up. Don't even worry about it.
Okay,
sugarless chocolate.
If you
let's look it up. Sugarless. Oh, there is apparently.
If you want to keep your figure,
Choco Perfection chocolate bars. This brand offers 5 different types of sugar-free chocolate to satisfy any craving. There you go. If you're on a diet and you have a boyfriend or a significant other that's watching their figure, get yourself some sugar-less chocolate.
Okay. Sounds good.
You're seeing the results here in the computer and you're doubting.
Oh, no. I'm not doubting you. That was more
I'm
of
me myself. I just...
No, I wasn't doubting him. I was just more like, I didn't know there was sugar-free chocolate. But I was going to bring up, Vic, not next week, but the following week, it could have been Charro's Days.
Could have, should have, would have.
Yes. But you know what? Let's leave that topic.
Isn't it Charro's Day virtually now?
Yes. I know they're doing costume contest, but I'm not sure
about...
You're
going to participate?
Maybe. You know what?
This year, this is sad. This year, because it's my senior year and I wanted to participate in a lot more stuff, I was going to buy that outfit or whatever.
Is it la cuera?
No.
What is it called?
Wait, is it a cuera?
A cuera? Is it a cuera? It's the one with the fringe, right?
I think so.
They're expensive. I think I know which one you're talking about.
Yeah, like this. Yeah,
I
sort
think
of.
They're
sort
called,
of.
What are they called?
Cuera.
Cuera?
It's cuera, yeah.
They're expensive. Okay, so I saw one at the Pulga Vic.
Or like just the top and then I'll worry about the rest.
Yeah. I found something... It's not a cuera, but it's a brown button down with gold buttons. It's so super
oh, that's
nice.
Cool.
It was at Corpus actually when I went.
Oh well, no one's gonna see it.
Well, you can still do a photo shoot.
That's true.
I mean, you can submit it.
Talking about photo shoots, are you going to get a photo shoot for your graduation? I mean, for your cap and gown?
Yes. And actually, Vic, should we announce? I feel like we should tell them our idea. I mean,
it's an idea. Like, nothing is promised. Relax.
Yes. But I did pitch to Vic a few weeks back that I feel like the Chunky Funky Hour should have a photo shoot for our graduation pictures together.
That'd be cool.
Like a session. We're going to have our own personal ones, but we should have one together just because it's like
together.
The Chunky Funky's last hour. Something like that, you know?
Vic, sad. That should be our last show. The Chunky Funky's last hour.
Yeah. Aye, Vic.
No.
Sad, forever sad.
I can hear people crying. It's okay, guys.
Cosas sad. But I mean, wouldn't that be cool, Vic, if we had like our own little like photo shoot? I think we should. Even if it's with our phones, like we can do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
100%.
But do you know, Vic, have you heard anything about, or has there been any reports about Ghetto Radio or the writer from any graduation announcements or anything?
Not
do you
yet.
Know anything?
Not yet. Not. Let me check Vaquero Radio. Nothing from Vaquero Radio. I don't think I saw anything from the newspaper. But I was going to say Coach Lou Hill died.
Yeah. RIP Mr. Weekend. Lou Hill. Yeah, I heard. It's very sad. I know a lot of students were impacted by that.
Yeah. I'm not sure. I don't think they said what he died of, but unfortunately, yeah.
Yeah, that's, you know, I heard that, like, there was really no complaints about him or anything. I mean, he was an Edinburgh staff member, so I never met him, but I know a lot of students really liked him, and he was a very positive figure in, you know, the Edinburgh campus for students.
Actually, from Vaquero Radio, in a news release Wednesday morning, which is today, it's Wednesday morning,
mm-hmm.
UTRGV Athletics announced its men's March basketball program will not play this weekend as they mourn the loss of head coach Lou Hill.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So the team was slated to play February 12 and 13 versus California Baptist University in Riverside, California. The Lancers are currently in the fourth seed in the Western Athletic Conference. If you want to read more into it, visit utrgvradio.com. Also, I think that's it also.
Yeah, well.
You have announcements to
oh,
make.
Yes. I wanted to announce one more thing, which is a career prep days, guys. A Career Center is having an elevator pitch workshop tomorrow, which is February 11th, Thursday, tomorrow, from 12 to 1 p.m. on Zoom. So basically what a elevator pitch is, guys, for the ones who don't know, is sometimes you have limited time to present yourself to an employer, and you want to do it within, let's say, 30 to 60 seconds, because that's typically an elevator ride. So Career Center is going to try and help you by perfecting or getting, you know, your elevator pitch top-notch. If you want to go ahead and attend this workshop, guys, make sure you RSVP on V-Link, and it's tomorrow from 12 to 1 p.m. Hopefully y'all can make it and perfect your elevator pitch. So see you there, hopefully.
Ask me if I have an elevator pitch. No, I don't.
Well, you should, Vic.
I should.
You should.
You know what? I am going to look into it.
You should
just
be.
Just because you said so.
You should be ashamed. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. It's okay. I mean, we're all, you know, managing time and homework. But yeah, make sure you guys attend that if you guys want to perfect your elevator pitch. It'll be fun. And you'll get something for, you know, the long-term use, I guess, which is your pitch.
Speaking of... Oh, I got to...
You lost your train of thought.
Yeah, Valentine's. What are you going to say? I know we touched bases.
Personally,
your sugar-free...
Personally, nothing.
Chocolate.
But, I mean, maybe I'll probably do homework. I mean, that's really what...
Treat yourself. There you go. With knowledge.
I don't think of it as a treat, but I guess.
I guess.
Maybe.
I guess, Jenny.
Maybe un elote. Oh. Un elote con hot
elotito. Isn't it gonna be cold this week?
This calls for an elote. Or for, I don't know, but pan dulce, maybe?
Pan dulce?
I heard it's gonna be like in the 30s. I'm not too sure.
Let's look at the weather then.
I'm not here for it. I'm not, y'all. I don't like cold weather.
I am. What's wrong with you? Okay. So tomorrow is what? Thursday. The lowest we're going to feel is 53 to 65 degrees. High 64 to 74.
But
Fridays, which is we should see a... Actually, tomorrow we should see a 40 to 70% chance of rain. On Friday, we should see a 20 to 30% chance of rain. Mm-hmm. Much cooler with the lows between 44 to 52 and highs of 57 to 61. So by Friday, we should start feeling a little bit cold. Saturday, 20% chance of rain. Much cooler with lows between the 43 and 51 degrees. Highs 54 to 62 degrees. Sunday and Monday, there should also be 20 to 30% chance of rain to 50% chance of rain. So, child, you know after
go on,
after tomorrow, we should be expecting rain.
Okay. So, Vic, the thing is, personally, I don't know about you, but I don't really have assembled outfits for winter or for like cold like days. So to me, it's like a hoodie.
I don't even have outfits.
Like jeans, a hoodie, and like my Vans. Let's go. Like I don't. People come out here with like trench coats and like these cute
they
beanies.
Look cool.
Yeah, and I'm just like, how do you have the time? You know what it is, Ovik? Mm. Some winter clothes is expensive, so I just don't really have like nice. I have like maybe one nice sweater mm-hmm. that's for the winter, but other than that, I really don't have any. So that's why I don't like the cold weather.
I completely understand. Well, guys, I hate to say this, but we've reached the end of our show for today, for this week.
Yes, we will be back next week.
Same time, same place.
And if you want us to talk about a certain topic, if you want us to promote a certain event or give a shout out, let us know, reach out, and we'll go ahead and do it.
Thank you guys for tuning in. You should expect this show up on YouTube,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yes, sir.
All right, guys. Enjoy your Valentine's if you have a significant other or a crush. You know, we're in a pandemic, but, you know, social distance.
And don't overdo it on the chocolate. Limit yourself.
This sugar-free chocolate.
Limit yourself. Yes, we learned that today.
All right. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Hey, guys.
You're listening to the Chunky Funky Hour with Nono Malo and
Big Big
on Vaquero Radio.
The station with the latest news
and the biggest hits.
Vaquero Radio,
the Valley's student station.